The DEA made a major bust this week. It was called Operation Logjam and targeted synthetic drugs in more than 30 states. Now, you might not have heard of them, but the DEA says plenty of people have. They're often sold as plant food or even bath salts. CNN's national correspondent Susan Candiotti is in New York this morning to tell us more about these drugs and why they are so popular. Susan, good morning.
Hi, Randy. They're called synthetic drugs because they're made from chemicals meant to mimic marijuana and cocaine, and they're cheaper, too. Some are sold as bath salts, plant food, but they're not what you'd feed your plant or put in your bathtub. Agents went after them in a big way this week, raiding storage units, homes, and head shops in more than 30 states from coast to coast, even Hawaii. More than 100 people were arrested. Now, it may not take these drugs off the street, but the DEA and ICE hope the sweep will get out the word.
We're sending a clear message to those who profit from the sale of these dangerous substances. You are nothing more than a drug trafficker, and we will bring you to justice. The web of connections between the suppliers and the distributors and the retailers is enormous and it's complex. But at DEA, we're experts in connecting the dots.
Now, some of these synthetics are not illegal, but if the ingredients are controlled substances, Randy, they can be.
So tell us more just about how these synthetic drugs are actually sold. I mean, what do they look like and who is buying them and using them?
Yeah, good question, Randy. Well, they're big with the younger crowd, usually under the age of 25. The fake drugs have all kinds of catchy names, and I'm not making this up, like Sexy Monkey, Alien Incense, and Tranquility. Now, bath salts that are burned, inhaled, or smoked, sometimes you see it like that, including fake marijuana. They're all with chemicals that the DEA says can be as dangerous as cocaine. The chemicals mainly come, Randy, from China and Southeast Asia.
Wow. Susan Candiotti, thank you very much for that report.
You're welcome.